With respiratory viral season in full swing, let's talk about one of the main tests that somebody might have done if they're experiencing respiratory virus symptoms, and that would be a flu test. And the flu stands for influenza, or the influenza virus. So if an individual is experiencing fever, chills, fatigue, or cough, they may go to their healthcare provider to confirm whether this is the flu or whether it's something else. To look at if it's the flu, the first thing that's going to be done is sample collection. One way may be through a nose or throat swab, and that's very common nowadays. But another way, which is a bit more traditional and might not be as common now, is through a nasal aspirate, which is where a saline solution is placed into the nose and then it's removed, and then that solution is what's used for later testing. The next step would be to run a diagnosis, and that can be done in two ways. The first would be through PCR. Now that's a longer method, but it's also more reliable. And that's going to be looking for genetic material of the influenza virus in the sample. The next would be a rapid diagnosis. That's going to be faster, usually less than 30 minutes. However, the results may be variable. And that test is going to be looking for proteins associated with the influenza virus that's in the sample. Now, the rapid diagnosis can also be done in two different ways. One is at a healthcare facility, and it's important to know that that means that that test was interpreted by a healthcare provider. But if it's done at home, those results would be interpreted by the individual. Now, the last thing is to look at the results of the test. If the results are positive, it means that somebody may have the flu and that they're could be prescribed an antiviral, such as Tamiflu, to help reduce the symptoms associated with the condition. But if the test is negative, other respiratory virus tests may be run, such as looking for COVID-19 or looking for RSV. Or it might not be related to a respiratory virus at all, and one's healthcare provider may provide additional testing that would be required to figure out what the symptoms might be associated with.